the continuation of the previous video, let's execute this code. So you can see the execution started. So it will take like a few minutes, as like the data is a lot to be retrieved using ChatGPT. So the execution is running at the moment. So I'll update it. Like you can see the even the time, everything. So once the execution is completed, we can able to see the data outputted here. So let's wait until this is completed. As you can see, the code is running here. In the meantime, the data is getting generated in the output columns. You can see there are a few errors which I will fix it later, but you can see like here, the if you take the company's owned by column, like the data are already outputted properly. See, like the Elon Musk is associated with the several companies, and you can see the briefing of the each company. Similarly for Richard Branson, you can see the briefing of each company. So similarly for all the things, like their data is outputted in the Excel sheets while the code is executing here. So imagine like we have did this for just 5 keywords. So imagine like if you have 1000 keywords, and if you have properly configured like 1000 outputs to be done like this for a blog, then you can see like you can easily create contents for like 1000 keywords in just like 5 to 10 minutes with using like proper app script using ChatGPT. Even there is no coding knowledge needed, as you can see like I have done literally with every proper prompts. So let's wait until this execution is completed. So in the meantime, you can see that like data is properly outputted for each of the terms one by one. So this is company's one by column. So the career column is also updated. So this is education column of Elon Musk. Only the family column is haven't fetched the data. We need to check that. And early life part is fetched as well with proper output. Even the age column and whois column has some errors. But other than that, like we can fix it because it's just a trial and error method, but like we are just following. So you can see this, it's outputted with the proper content in the field which we have mentioned. So I hope like you have learned like how you can use ChatGPT prompt and create app script, and you can just create the content. So you can see like in this video, like I have covered these two factors as well: creating the app script using ChatGPT prompts and linking them with the Excel sheet and running the prompt using Excel. So with this, like in this video I have covered like what is programmatic SEO and how to create app script using ChatGPT and how to run the app script in the Excel sheet and output the content. So now the next question will be like how to import this content as a post to the WordPress. So this is the critical part which will be covered in the following video. So my next video will be on this. Like in this video I'm just going to end here, like as I need to keep it simple about covering the basics of programmatic SEO and creating the contents in bulk. In the upcoming video, I will show you like how I am going to import this particular generated contents to the WordPress website in a properly formatted, organized manner. So you know you don't want to do any kind of optimization works in the target posts which you are going to import in the WordPress. So imagine if you have like 1000 or 10,000 keywords in the Excel with the proper data sets, you can just use the ChatGPT, and using open API key you can create bulk contents and import it in the WordPress. Still, programmatic SEO is a huge success, and like, but the thing is like you need to give importance to few factors and keep it in the right way, and you should not spam Google like publishing irrelevant contents. If your contents is readable, user friendly, unique, informative, obviously Google is going to index them. So in the coming video I will show you like how I'm going to import this to the WordPress blog, and how I'm going to use the indexing tool to properly index those bulkly published pages, and even I will show you like how these blogs are going to improve the ranks and traffic organically. So if you have any questions, or if you have any specific requirements with related to programmatic SEO, you can just drop it in the comments. I will definitely cover up in the coming videos. So thank you. So if you're not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe, so you will get the latest updates from me. Thank you.